So hey guys, this is another video tutorial of Windows System Programming. In this tutorial, I'm going to cover the semaphore. I have already made a video of semaphore. Check tutorial number 14. On that tutorial, I covered the only the create mutex and open mutex, and only for that. Then in this tutorial, we'll see the more explanation about the semaphore, and we'll see the application in later video tutorial. So semaphore is a normal the integer variable, just like our normal declaration of any integer variable. But in Windows, each and everything is treated as a object. So this one is the synchronization object that maintains an account between 0 and a specific maximum value. It's a replacement of mutual exclusion mutex. Mutex has some limitation. So it can have access by only two interlock or atomic operation. If you are not aware of that interlock or atomic operation, then you can check tutorial number 25. So there are two atomic operation or interlock operation, is wait and signal. In semaphore, there is no mutual ownership, but in case of mutex, it has. Basically, those who lock the resource, only those can release the lock. That means they are maintaining the mutual ownership. But in case of semaphore, anyone can lock the resources and release the resources. Two types of semaphore. First one is the binary semaphore and counting semaphore. And there are two states of semaphore. First one is the signal state, when count greater than 0, and non-signal means 0. So counter is a list of tasks waiting to access resources. So if you see the semaphore working, there are two atomic operation of semaphore, that is the wait operation and signal operation. In wait operation, simply decrement the count. So first you have to initialize the semaphore with 1, then it becomes the signal state. Then it performs the wait operation. Wait operation performed, then S becomes 0. Then we have to perform our task and signal to the another resources. In Windows, wait for signal object API is used for the wait operation. And signal operation simply increment the count each time a thread releases the semaphore. So we have already seen semaphore is in the signal state. So after performing the wait operation, it becomes 0. Then this S cannot be negative values. Then after performing the task, this two wait and signal, between that this one is the critical section. Then signal operation performed, then simply it increment the value. In Windows, release semaphore API is used for the signal operation. So we have seen that the semaphore two types, binary semaphore, it can have only two values, either 0 or 1. Very useful to solving the critical section problem. If S becomes 1, then we can access only one resource at a time. Counting semaphore, it can have multiple value of count. Semaphore initialization tells that how many resources we can access simultaneously. If S equal to 5, then we can access 5 resources simultaneously. Context switching between the process or thread happen at any point of time. So if you compare this mutex, if you compare the semaphore in mutex, then there are certain advantages we'll see. We can solve critical section problem. A solution for solving the critical section problem must satisfy the three conditions. First one is the mutual exclusion. Only one resource can execute in critical section. So semaphore application is solving the critical section problem using the binary semaphore. So here there are two resources, resource 1 and resource 2. And the initial value of semaphore S equal to 1. And this 2 is the critical section, and between that there is one shared resource. So anyone can enter in this. Let's say suppose resource 1 is trying to enter into this critical section. So it performs the decrement, it becomes 0, then it will access. But resource 2 can come? No, because here the wait operation is already 0, so resource 2 will wait. And then after entering from the critical section, we are giving the signal, so the semaphore value becomes 1. That means resource 2 can come and then access this resource. If we see the second condition, progress, if there are no resource in critical section and some resource want to enter in critical section, then one of these resource can enter critical section. That means no other resource can block it them to entering the critical section. If you see the semaphore application, deciding order of execution, there are n number of process, let's say, but I want only P3, only P1, P2, P3 can come into the critical section. So what I'll do here, I'm taking the two semaphore, initial value both is 0. So let's say the execution step I want like that, P3, then P1, then P2. So first I'll do here, I'm not using any wait operation before P3. Directly I'm using the signal S1. So what will happen? S1 value is 0, S2 value is 0, S2 comes in P2, no, because already 0. S1, P1 process will execute first, no, because S1 is already 0. So we have to jump in P3, we are giving the signal of S1, then P1 will execute, and then after that we are giving the signal to the S2. So here the S2 value becomes 1, so process P2 will execute. Third one is the bounded waiting. There is a bound on the number of times that other resource allowed to the critical section. In semaphore applications, restrict number of resources, that is the resource management. Here there are 5 resources and they are trying to access the shared data. But I have already initialized the semaphore with 4. So let's say R1 is coming, then decrementing the value 3. So after that R2 will come, because this S value is not 0. So R2 will come, then R3 will come, then R4 will come, and then this S value is 0. Whenever R5 is trying to come into the critical section, it will never come because already it is the 0. That means R5 will wait. So if you see the summary, binary semaphore used when there is only one shared resource to handle. To handle more than one shared resources of same type, then use the counting semaphore. So in general, we are talking about wait and signal PS or VS. So in Windows, wait for signal object is the wait operation it will perform, and release semaphore is performed for the signaling. In Linux, we are same wait and same post. There are two API which we use. So if you see the create semaphore API, return type is handle, and there are 4 arguments. First one is the security attribute, so by default we have to keep null here. Initial count and maximum count, these are two tricky things, don't get confused. So initial value of semaphore, so if we are putting here 0, so that means the semaphore is non-signal state. If 1, then semaphore in signal state. If this things in maximum count, number of resources, if I am using here 1, so I am using this semaphore as a binary semaphore. If n greater than 1, that means the counting semaphore, we can use any number. And last argument is the name. So if you wish, then you can put a name for your semaphore. So I'll use this 5 APIs. First one is the create semaphore, release semaphore, create thread, wait for single object, and close handle. You can check tutorial number 10, how to create thread, and tutorial number 14, create semaphore API. Also, you can follow me on Google Plus, link in the description box. So our C, this one is the semaphore object. There are so many theories are there. Check the description box. We have already seen the create semaphore API. So jump to the release semaphore function. Basically, it will take the 3 arguments. First one is the handle for the semaphore, release count. Release count tells about the counter value, and then previous count So if you want to use that, if you see the pointer to the variable to receive the previous count for the semaphore, this parameter can be null if the previous count is not required. If required, then you can use, otherwise no. Return type handle, same thing. If the function fails, the return value is zero, and we can print the error number with the help of getLastError function. This one is the most important thing, wait for single object function. Wait until the specified object is in the signal state or the timeout interval elapses. So syntax, if you check, return type is a divot type, means integer. Takes two argument, first one is the handle for the semaphore and wait millisecond. If you write here infinite, then it always return immediately if milli second in infinite, the function will return only when the object is a signal. So I'll use that. And last one is the close handle function. Basically, it takes the handle of that. So moving to the programming part. Here, I have already created the two thread. First step is we have to create the semaphore. Second step is I'm creating here the two thread. I have already created. Actually, I am assuming that you know how to create thread. Then step 3 is wait for single object for the thread 1 and thread 2. Then closing the handle for the thread 1 and thread 2. And last step, we have to use the close handle for the semaphore. So I am using here one global variable handle h semaphore. Then here I have to use semaphore. Now I'm using here the create semaphore API. Create semaphore API. First one is the security attribute. So I'll put it here null security attributes. And second one is the initial count. So initial count is, let's say, one. Signal state maximum count is one. And then name for the semaphore. Here I am writing initial state. Then basically it will tell about the number of resources. So resources maximum count, and then we have to use here name. So I'm not using any name for the semaphore. If you wish, then you can use. Then after that, I'm checking the condition. Then step 2 is creating the thread. The first argument is the security attribute. It will tell the stack size. So if you are putting here 0, it will take the default stack size. And this one is our thread function name. And parameter we are passing no. Then creation flag and thread ID, I'm using here 00. If you wish, then you can print the thread ID also. So step 3 is wait for the single object for thread 1 and thread 2, then closing the handle. Now last step is we have to perform the close handle for semaphore. So I'm using here h semaphore. Now if you come here in thread function, first we have to use the wait for single object h semaphore. I'm using the handle. Then time infinite. Once it will signal, it will return immediately. So C out, I'm printing a normal statement. End of this line, I'm using here the critical section, and then release semaphore API. Semaphore. First argument is the handle of the semaphore. So handle of the semaphore is h semaphore. Then release count 1, and then previous count we want no. So that's it. So it's time to compile our code. So first we have to build. Build succeeded. Now we are going to run our code. So basically, this example is the binary semaphore. They are accessing one by one this critical section. So this was the basic programming of semaphore, means binary semaphore, how we are going to be used. If you like this video, do hit comment, share, and subscribe.